Okay, my name is Moses Kemibaro, and I'm the Business Development Director at DotSavvy. DotSavvy is what we call a digital agency, which means we build websites, we do multimedia presentations, we host websites, we do internet marketing, and a whole bunch of other things. In this respect, when I think about Kenyan music, when I think about Kenyan music and the potential of Kenyan music online, already, you know, you can see what our artists are doing. The other day, Wahoo won a prize and so forth. But the biggest challenge for many of these artists is how they can be more global, how can people can find them on the internet, and how they can leverage technology as a key way of actually growing their market, growing the number of people who hear their music and so forth. So from my point of view, if you look at Kenyan music, I think already there are many possibilities. A lot of content in terms of Kenyan music is now online. People are putting their information and their music on sites like YouTube, on Facebook. They're building profile pages. They're marketing their products and their music over there. And I think the next phase, obviously, is going to be how they can start to distribute cost-effectively and profitably their music and their productions online. And I think how this is going to happen is next year we're expecting a ICT bill to go through, which will enable e-commerce and other sort of payment processing and payment facilities online to be activated. And I think that means ultimately that the market will grow. People will be able to actually hear about our music more effectively, and in essence, you know, the musicians will also earn more money because now they're really going to be able to be global without incurring major costs in terms of marketing and so forth.
Are our artists embracing technology?
Oh yeah, I mean, I think Kenyan artists are definitely online. Like earlier in my presentation, Wahoo is there, Jua Kali, all these artists are there, and they're actually putting their content online on YouTube, on Facebook and so forth. So they are online, they are definitely technically competent. It wasn't the case maybe 2-3 years ago when we were last at the Kenya Music Week. But right now it's very encouraging to see that most of them have some sort of web presence, even if it's basically a simple profile page on Facebook or a proper full-blown website. They are going online, they are realizing the value of being online. Okay, we're very passionate about the music industry in Kenya. To be quite honest, we've not yet managed to make major headway with the artists themselves in terms of music. There was a time when we were talking to Valerie Kimani about doing something for her. I suspect one of the biggest challenges is cost. They can't really afford very much, and they spend more time in making sure their music sounds good and doing events and so forth. I think the way forward for the music industry here and where DotSavvy might get involved is maybe in building a social network or portal where for a fairly limited cost, a very low cost, an artist from Kenya could have a strong online presence on this portal with samples of their music and helping them market them through others' websites. But I think where we might get involved is maybe building a portal for the music industry in Kenya.